righteousness. And understood and accepted the gospel of salvation through faith in Christ alone, apart from the works of the law. And that word, sola gratia, is just another way to say, in modern vernacular, grace alone. Justification. In other words, I put it as acquittal. You were guilty, and now you have been acquitted. You didn't have to do anything. You didn't have to go out on probation and prove that you were worthy to be released. No, you were granted full acquittal. And your guarantee of eternal life is based upon that acquittal. Now, there's the work that God does, that he would do in our lives. But that work that he does in our lives is not what saves us. And that's what many don't understand. It is what he has declared concerning us that saves us, apart from any works that we do. But the Church of Rome taught that justification involved not only the declaration that you are acquitted, you're no longer guilty, but that it also involved the work of the Holy Spirit in your life. That's how we are saved. But Luther came up with a whole other dynamic, as he stated in Romans, and that was that justification by faith alone is how we're saved. It is a legal act that is completely outside of ourselves. Anytime man gets involved, it takes the whole process. It messes up the whole process. Another term that's used by Paul in the New Testament is accepted in the beloved. Accepted in the beloved has nothing to do. You see, many people, many Christians believe that let your good works outweigh your bad. And that's what God's going to determine as to whether or not you can be saved. Then there are those who won't come to accept the gospel because they believe that I'm pretty good already. I never heard anybody. They don't understand that all have sinned and have come short of the glory of God. Sin is not just actions. Sin is who you are apart from Christ. So even if you are a morally upright person, you don't lie, you don't steal, you don't kill, that doesn't guarantee you a right. Because you are a child of Adam. And all the children of Adam have that stamp of condemnation upon them, because the whole race was condemned as a result of what Adam did. It was between the years 1515-1516 that Luther began to discover that the righteousness of God was not based on a sinner meeting some standard of behavior that would justify them in the sight of God, but rather was a free gift of God's mercy. As sinners were, and as the key word, they declared to be righteous. Not because they were good, but because God is good. We're saved because God is good, and we believe in His Son, Jesus Christ. He saved us because He is good, and so we're good. Luther's anxieties have been quelled by the simple words of Romans. These are the scripture texts that Luther, that got Luther's attention. Now we know that what things soever the law says, is saying to them who are under the law, that every mouth may be stopped, and all the world may become guilty before God. So how many are guilty? The whole world is guilty. How do you free yourself from that guilt? If not by doing good works. You know, many people come to Christ and make a mistake and thinking, I've come to Christ now, He saved me, and now I'm going to pay God back through good works because of what He has done. You can never pay Him back. So when they fail to pay God back, so to speak, they become discouraged. And they doubt the sincerity of their commitment. So therefore, by the deeds of the law, shall no flesh be justified in his sight. And that includes the deeds of the law that you do with the help of Jesus. So many people have the idea that, yes, justified by faith, we're not saved by works, but we're saved by Jesus working in us. This is what Rome was teaching. And this is what Luther tried to counteract. by the deeds of the law. So notice that's been justified. That you can put the word saved there in his sight. For by the law is the knowledge of sin. But now the righteousness of God without the law is manifested, been witnessed by the law and the prophets. Even the righteousness of God, which is by faith in Jesus Christ, unto all and upon all them that believe. And there's no difference. So how do we receive this righteousness? It's by believing. But believing in and of itself only happens because of grace. If there were no grace, we wouldn't have the capacity to believe or to understand the things of God. And that believing is just the instrument by which we receive that grace. So there's no difference. And so the reason why I said there's no difference, because Paul was talking to both the Jewish and the Gentile audience. The Jews were saying that you're saved by the law. The Gentiles say, what does it place us? We're not under the law. So he's saying, by these two laws, no flesh justified. By the law of knowledge is the knowledge of sin. And then the key word here is freely, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. So this grace is free. And this word here, Romans 3:25, says, whom God has set forth to be a propitiation through faith in his blood